drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot.
Call me Cardi B. I run this shit like cardio.
Oh my God.
It's me, Issa. You just wanted to stop by and say we're so thankful for your weekly podcast. They're hilarious.
My name is Letitia, and I'm thankful for beautiful friends and family.
What a way to start off this Thanksgiving, Friendsgiving yes. episode with yes. our viewers, our listeners, everyone who tunes in every week to hang with us. And to share what they're thankful for and what they're grateful for. And that's something that we try to practice no matter what the week is, no matter what the episode is, because life is good. Meanwhile, we have a special guest in the house.
Woohoo! Someone Look we're at very thankful for.
Woo! Wren! She walked in and she dropped her fur like a queen does. Oh, Wren is in the house. Hi, Wren. How are you? Can you say hi?
Hi, Wren.
Can you, now, you just turned two recently.
I can.
Yeah.
Can you say...
Oh, really?
Can you say, I'm Wren?
I'm Wren.
Yay!
What we have in store for you today is something that we have been looking forward to.
Yes.
We always look forward to. And that is some good eats and good treats, because we know that this is not only the season to be thankful. It's a season to stuff our faces.
Yes.
It's a season to break out the stretchy pants.
Cheat day all holiday season long.
If it doesn't have an elastic in it, I don't want to see it. But yeah, so we've got SugaChef that's going to be joining us and showing us not only delicious things that we can make, but most importantly, easy things that we can make for uncoordinated people like me that have zero time, that just wants to get it done, but still wants to take part in family traditions and still wants to do things with the family and make memories and make things that, you know, we're going to remember and hopefully be able to pass down to their kids. So that's going to be fun. But it's still all the rage. A week has we're maybe a few days in
yep.
to the frozen craze.
Into the end.
Beautiful, beautiful show. I love the first Frozen.
Yes.
Wren doesn't watch a lot of TV, but I did let her watch the trailer.
Oh, this is garbage.
I know, Into the Unknown is not a good idea going in there.
No.
It was also a big week for Wren. Not only did Frozen 2 come out, but Wren made her debut on the screen as well.
Oh my goodness.
You can see right here, she was part of the Frozen party segment over at Fox 5, and Maria with confetti teepees did this fabulous icy display. I even said, I was like, my icy girl making her
yes!
debut
Wren.
On TV. And, you can just see how adorable it is with the teepees, the frozen pillows, the blankets. That's something that's really easy to do. And Maria with confetti teepees is awesome. So if you are in the Washington area, look her up. She does play dates. She does sleepovers. She puts it all out there and she packs it all up, which makes it easy for us parents. So there's this new study out, Brittany. Did you hear about this?
I saw a little something on your Instagram.
Well, this one is about how Friendsgiving is becoming more popular than Thanksgiving.
Oh, interesting.
Friends gather, people would rather gather with their friends than go and be with all their families.
Shut up!
You don't talk to me like that!
Now, I didn't think that we needed a scientific study.
I know.
To prove this point. But apparently somebody did. So now it's in the news headlines, it's in the cycle, whatever. But what I found was kind of odd is after talking to a few people, even colleagues over at Fox 5, they were saying how they actually chose to do Friendsgiving over the family Thanksgiving, the tradition. And I'm like, listen.
What's wrong with y'all's family?
You got to do it in addition, but you only got one family, people.
There's nothing like making sweet potato pie with my grandma every Thanksgiving, every year. I mean, it's a tradition. You know what I mean? Cooking with my mom, Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade.
We don't do all that. And that brings me to my next, my Thanksgiving fail.
Yeah.
So we like the Boston market. Okay. This is how
it's
I
real.
Roll.
It's true.
Right? You know, they order the turkey ahead of time, you pick it up, you go and you get your cream spinach, your macaroni and cheese, you get some extra rolls. So I hosted Thanksgiving one year. This was maybe 4 years ago. It was while I was in my condo over in Reston. And I ordered everything. I got off work, I went, picked it up.
Mm-hmm.
We get to the house, everybody's headed over, and all you have to do is heat it up.
Literally.
Right? This is what makes then no real dishes to clean.
Like I said, Angie can't cook, but she sure can bake.
And I know how
so
to use a microwave.
Work. Yeah. That's
I
a
go
fact.
To put the stuff in, the microwave is broken.
What the
f? Are you kidding
the
me?
The microwave, everybody's on their way. I've made this beautiful ornate table because we know that I can make a table. I can dress it up.
Mm-hmm.
And literally, mm-hmm. the microwave will not work. I cannot heat up any sides. So we can heat the turkey. Everything is cold. The gravy, the mashed potatoes, the string beans.
That is an epic fail.
The stuffing, ice cold. Everybody shows up.
And you know Bob's mad already.
Yeah. Well, I had to go to the condo, had like a little bit of like a community kitchen.
Right.
With one microwave.
Right.
We spent 2 hours going up and down the elevator because it's a condo. Trying to heat up these sides to bring right. it. So like 4 hours later, everybody got to eat. That was my Thanksgiving. You're welcome. Happy Thanksgiving. But we were all together. We watched a
That's
movie.
That's what matters.
And it made a memory and it was fine. So.
Well, here goes my epic fail. You talk about movies. I can't ever make it to the movies because the itis gets me every time. I'm knocked by like yeah. 3 o'clock. It's
so
over.
You don't go see the movies at
Done.
All.
Yeah. I will let the rest of the family go while I sit back and hang in the bed
yeah.
and watch Netflix instead.
Oh my gosh. That sounds good too.
oh no!
My goodness. I don't even know what's happening.
Wren, come here. Come here. Wren, you gotta be right.
Brittany, I don't know if you're gonna recover.
Please excuse this interruption as we clean up the set.
Thankfully, this holiday, we have some help.
So excited for this. I mean, look at this.
It smells so good.
Wren's been trying to keep her hands all on top of this. We've had to keep them off.
Yes. And we want to be able to show you how you can. Yes, you're welcome. You're welcome. Without further ado, because we are hungry and we need to get something in this girl's mouth so she stops talking.
Right.
Please welcome to the Oh My Goff Show.
Sugar.
One of the sweetest guests we've ever seen.
Sugar Chef
in the house.
Can you grab Sugar's chair?
Oh, she just said to put your headphones on. Sugar Chef, I'm so glad that baby Wren, Wren let you in so that we can do this interview.
I know, right? She's security
you know?
Here, right?
She has not learned yet. You do not bite the hands or cut off the hand
that feeds you. Right?
Exactly. Tell us a little bit about you because you are a mainstay. You are a staple in this community.
Well, you know, believe it or not, I grew up in the Northeast Corridor of Washington, D.C., so I'm a native,
yes!
a true native Washingtonian.
D.C. or nothing.
D.C. or nothing. That's right. I'm the youngest of seven.
Wow.
Most of my family's here. I have some family on the outskirts of D.C., but most of my family's here. So, mm-hmm. you know, I'm a hometown boy.
Have you always loved making yummy things?
My mom made the most delicious sweet potato pies and dinner rolls. So I would be in the kitchen helping her do her sweet potato pies and her dinner rolls.
I would love to do a taste test with your mom and my
like
grandmamas.
in my Boston
like
market.
That.
Right.
you know, I see you all the time on TV, and you always have great ideas, especially for the families, especially for people who are like me. Who really just don't have time to cook and to bake and to do, you know, but we want to, but the want is there. Like,
right.
you want to be able to do that stuff.
Right. Well, you know, the most important thing, please don't get intimidated. And I think personally, I think the holidays is really, if you're like a novice cooker, you're kind of shaking the kitchen a little bit at the beginning of the kitchen. I think the holidays is like a bad time to try new recipes.
Because
<Right. laughs> if they don't work out, if the failure is like, you're kind of, you know, you're in trouble with the dessert. So I think if you do like a trial and error, kind of warm your family up if you want to try recipes.
Right.
Or even if you have like friends. Okay, let me try this recipe with my friend and give it to them or bring it to work and just see what people say. So I think baking mixes and things like that are your best friend.
BFF.
First and foremost, though, do we have a favorite Thanksgiving, something that you love to make during this time of year?
actually, I like to make my way to someone's house and not have to bring anything. Or I'll stop
that's
at a store and get something. You know what I mean?
Everybody's asking you to make stuff.
I know, right? My sister's like, oh, we're having Thanksgiving. You're coming over. Yeah, right. Well, can you bring a peach cobbler? And didn't you say you were going to make dinner rolls? I was like, you know what? How about I bring the turkey?
I was about to ask. So you cook more than just desserts, I'm sure.
Well, I did actually in the beginning, but I lean more towards just sweets now. I can't because I have so many friends that, and I have amazing cooks. I have amazing cooks in my family, so I don't need to do the savory stuff.
Really?
Yeah.
To get competitive?
No, not at all. Because they know I can
Kitchen
beat them
Wars.
In desserts.
Yeah. Oh, really?
Yeah. Yeah, they know. They know. They know what time it is.
They don't need a watch. Okay. All right. What we got here?
Okay. So this is what I brought. Some of my holiday favorites, of course, is a staple that I do around the holidays because I kind of ship it all over, is my signature caramel popcorn. So that's a really great, easy thing you can do. You can use microwave popcorn. You can just find a little simple. It's like four ingredients. Spread it on a sheet pan, bake it in the oven for like about a half an hour, and then you're done.
What are those
like, how simple
ingredients?
Is that?
Yeah.
Yeah. What are the ingredients?
Well, it's just butter, sugar, a little bit of water, not four ingredients, maybe like five or six. Corn syrup.
You know how these chefs do. We doctor it up.
So, of course, we have our gingerbread. And so that's another easy, super easy, fun activity to do. As opposed to doing your standard gingerbread cookies, you can do with your daughters I don't want to say an ugly sweater gingerbread. I would say cute sweater gingerbread cookies. You can buy the gingerbread cookies. You can buy the icing. It's a fun activity for the kids. Put them at a table. Keep them busy. Get them out of your way.
I'm assuming that this is a gender-neutral gingerbread
cookie.
It's a
gender-neutral gingerbread.
This is
yes,
a gingerbread
absolutely.
People, right?
That's a gingerbread okay. person. It's yeah, a gingerbread person. No.
Did you hear about that? That was a recent story. Like someone went into a shop in New York and was like, why is it called Gingerbread Man? It should be gingerbread people, whatever, blah, blah. So he changed it. And
it's a gingerbread person.
A gingerbread person.
Well, we're in 2019. Yeah. You know how it goes. Yeah, we can quality be, is
it's novelty, it's funny, and whatever. But
yeah, I'm going to call it a gingerbread person.
I have always taken it upon myself to draw the genders on things like the gingerbread on my dolls. I remember when I gave my Barbies nipples.
Oh my God.
I know we're getting
okay.
Wait, the Ken doll?
No, the women.
Because they
were missing
them.
It. They did not look
yes.
right. That's not what Chin looked like. Okay, now
just
we're
being honest.
I'm just saying, like, when along the lines of decorating, right. I mean, this gingerbread person can be whoever they want.
It can be whoever.
Okay.
Exactly.
Whatever you want it to be.
It could be Taylor a guy, or Taylor a girl.
I made hot chocolate bombs. So it's literally,
is
yes.
that what this is?
Okay, again, we're talking about semi-homemade, easy in the kitchen. You can buy chocolate mousse mix in the store already made.
Okay.
You take a little packet of your favorite hot chocolate, not with marshmallows because that tend to be a little too hard, and you mix it into the mousse.
Okay.
If you wanted to do, well, I made it using a mold, but if you wanted to use like your favorite glass, you know, you can use like a short glass, you can use like a martini glass, and you can layer it that way. You can take some Lorna Doone shortbread cookies, sandwich it that way. You can take something crunchy like texture, maybe like your favorite cereal, crunch it up really fine, and layer it that way. So you have the mousse, you have the cookie, you have, of course, mine's a little fancier than that. But again, I'm giving you homemade alternative versions of that. Okay, I brought you my favorite gingerbread cheesecake.
First of all,
I kind of came up with that recipe a couple years ago.
Looks bomb.
By the way, everybody
so
was
like
salivating.
Yeah, but I'm taking that home.
Not before I cut a slice.
You can have one of our gender neutral gingerbread men.
There
but
you go.
That's about it.
The shade.
Right.
As I gave this to us to split, and it's just been taken over.
Hey, y'all see this?
That looks incredible. Let me get in there.
Yeah, so it's chocolate mousse. It's a hazelnut praline, a shortbread cookie. It's
Stop
covered
it.
In ganache.
Insane.
So the cheesecake is something with a gingerbread crust, ginger snap crust rather.
Mm-hmm.
So you can buy the crust pre-made if you wanted to.
Okay.
The shell. They have the instant cheesecake mixes that you can buy.
Mm-hmm.
You can add some spices to that. Mm-hmm. Of course, mine isn't instant, but you can add some spices to that. Mine has a little molasses in it to give it some color. So you can mix that into that as well. And I just decorated it with some gingerbread mix. I want people to really enjoy the experience of cooking. And it's really not about making it perfect. It's about making something that your family will enjoy.
That's what it comes back to.
Yeah.
Well, that looks delicious. I cannot wait to dig in.
Right. So then, of course, I bought some fancier things. Everything could be homemade because you can buy the little shells. You can buy the lemon curd. The meringue you may have to make on top of the little lemon tarts. The mice is something, of course, you can use a pre-made chocolate cookie. Again, you can pipe the mousse on top.
Oh, that's so cute.
Your kids can decorate it.
It's a mouse.
You cater?
The opera cake, yes. Opera cake, you can make that.
Send me
homemade, Angie. Listen, send me homemade,
Angie. What you doing December 8th? I got a Dollywood party. I got a plan.
Dolly, was that the theme this year?
Yes.
Theme this
year. The theme.
Okay, so you have a thing with Dolly.
I mean, you both are stumbling over our words.
Any favorite like apps or resources that you go to or that would be good places for people to start?
That you know, Pinterest, believe it or not.
Really?
I mean, I just got into Pinterest, but I find a lot of inspiration from Instagram too.
Yes. Right. Oh my gosh, with all the DIY foodie accounts and stuff.
Right. And it's like anything else. It's like anything else you like look at.
My mental health takes a slaying on Instagram.
I know, right?
I'm glad that it's working for you.
Yeah. Well, you know, I get distracted, I get sidetracked, but I usually save a lot. But you look at things and just things and people inspire you. So you're always, when you're creatively driven like me, things always inspire you.
I always like to ask my guests what's some of the best advice that they've ever gotten or maybe perhaps words that they live by on a daily basis. Do you have anything that comes to mind?
G-rated. Okay, professionally,
I love it.
One of the things professionally this one chef taught me is live it, love it, learn it, and get on with it.
Ooh, I like that.
You know
that.
What I mean? Yeah, live it, love it, learn it, and get on with it. And that was when I was thinking about transitioning to another job. And she says, listen, this is how it's going to be in this business. You got to live it, love it, learn it, and then sometimes it's time to move on.
Oh my gosh,
I like that. Yeah? I know.
That's so true.
Right.
I like
it. But the biggest personally, the biggest piece of advice that my mom gave me was she would say, you know, she was full of them. She would say, baby, you know, everybody doesn't want to see you do well.
That is so true.
Yeah, you got to pay attention to those who don't clap.
She would
We talk about that all the time.
She said, baby, everybody don't want to see you do well. Everybody's not going to wish you well. And the ones that wish you well, sometimes you have to look back at them and see if they're really genuine. So, you know, I kind of keep those things. She was full of
that. Yeah, no, I love that. It kind of plays in, you know, there's certain things that I always tell my, you know, self. It doesn't matter what career that you've chosen to go through. I think everything is similar. You know, I think we all go through similar things. And
absolutely.
And one thing that stuck with me early on from the very beginning was, you know, because I used to get stressed out about that type of stuff, right? You know, what do other people think? Like, why don't they want, you know, to support me? Why don't, you know, all these questions,
because you have such a great heart and you just understand why you can't get it back sometimes.
But this one guy told me, you know, every second you spend thinking about somebody else is a second you're taking away from yourself, and, you know, and what you could be doing. And that has always, it always brings me back. And I'm like, yes, gosh, I'm wasting these seconds, these minutes when I could be focused on the next thing to, you know, to help my dream still unfold. And so, I really
like
that. I'm
going through that now. It's like,
And I always tell Ange, protect your energy.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
That's why we got candles up in here and rocks.
Axe.
Right.
Brittany brought the rocks.
Crystals.
The smoke, the crystals, the tea. So
right. You got to keep the zen. You got to keep that positive.
You got Justin Bieber in a corner, Bruce Lee in another. You
are Snoop lit up.
This is a safe space.
Cardi over there.
Yes.
Tornado hits.
The cuss a bitch.
Earthquake.
We in this joint.
You come to the stew, okay?
Right.
Because you are protected. This is a safe space. Place.
Right. Thank you for having me. It was such a pleasure. I've been dying to get on this show.
I know. You're so
sweet. It's so fun. So thank you so much.
This is, I mean, first of all, Angie, I'm cutting into that cake.
I know you are,
but
you don't get...
You could take it home, but I'm telling her now, I am trying that cake, okay?
It's okay.
This was amazing. I didn't try this yet. Do you want to eat some good food?
Look.
It's so pretty. She doesn't want to break into it.
Oh, you're going to... Oh, fancy. Okay. SugaChef, where can people find out more about you?
Social media, I'm on everything at SugaChef. SugaChef. That's it.
Yeah.
Chef Padua. I think Chef Padua at SugaChef. SugaChef. Yeah. On Twitter. I always forget my Twitter handle, but everything is at SugaChef. Yeah. SugaChef.com, SugaChef.com.
So, well, SugaChef, this has been such a delight.
It's been an amazing time.
You're amazing. We are going to cut into this cake. I cannot wait.
Cut the cake.
Oh,
cut the cake.
There's cheese.
And eat it too. Cut the cake. Cut the cake. Cut the cake. Eat it too. Cut the cake.
This is a perfect time to talk about family traditions. We all know I love a good holiday, but I'm also big on creating your own traditions, and something that I started with the family many, many years ago, I think it's when Adora started school, was called Fall Feast. And typically we try to do this in September or October, but you can do it later. And it's a time that even before Thanksgiving and all the hustle and bustle starts, that you get together with the family and you can decorate it fall, like the changing of the seasons, and really celebrate, you know, a new clean slate, a fresh start.
Yes.
You know, we do that. We tend to do that a lot in the spring, but I feel like in the fall, that's when school is starting back up. That is when, you know, that's the beginning of a lot. And so I started this tradition where we would do that. We would do a lot of fun baked goods. This year, we, even though I don't cook, we made our own pizzas.
Ooh.
We did not eat all of them. But it was really, the kids were like, this is super fun. We did the dough, the pre-made dough. We made our own pizzas. We talk about what our goals are, the one goal that we have, you know, for the school year, whether it's to be a better reader or a better writer, or, you know, to find more friends. And then they always look forward to, they never really appreciated it until like now, because I think they're a little older, but I wanted to give them something every year of school that they could, by the end of the year, have like a compilation of it. And so I started getting them these little glass stars, and they're like ornaments. And so you can see here, they're different colors, they're handmade, and on each of them I have the year, and I have their name, and then I usually put a quote, which is kind of like their guiding light for that year. Like for Adora, when she started kindergarten, her says a whole new world.
Aww.
And then for Bob, it's, I think one of them says like, roar on or something, you know, and it had a dinosaur.
Very Bob-esque.
Find your roar. And so they used to get the, you know, stars and be like, oh, cool. You know, and
right.
They put it aside, and then they want the candy or whatever, because we usually give them books and a stuffed animal. But now it's like, are we going to get the stars? You know, what's my star going to say? And so by the end of this, they're going to have this whole collection of stars that they can either hang or use on the tree or whatever. But and it's kind of like a marker along the years. And it's really nice when we can lay them all out like this and we can read through them, and it kind of shows their growth and these different milestones.
And then one day they're going to have a box full of stars. I can see it now when Adora is in high school, which will be crazy when that day comes.
I know, it's so scary.
But that's why traditions are so special.
Yeah.
You know?
All the way to when you go to college. When's that going to be?
Never.
And so that's just something, and you know, if you want to do something along those lines, do it, but it's really a way to celebrate. You know, you get so wrapped up in the back to school stuff, and so we usually just wait a couple months till we get settled in, and then we say, how is it going?
Yeah.
You know, what do you need to work on? And then by then we also have an analysis from the teacher of, you know, how they're doing.
Yeah.
But it's called Fall Feast, and it's really, really fun. And if you have any questions or need any help planning yours, you can do it in the spring too. Let me know.
Yep.
Another update. I am emceeing the Reston Holiday Parade, one of the best in the world.
VA.
Yes. USA Today has named it one of the best parades in the nation.
Oh,
again,
love that.
You can vote again this year for it, and with good reason, because this really is our Macy's Thanksgiving Day parade for the area. It has those big balloons that make its way down Market Street, a bunch of dance troops. We actually have stormtroopers, Santa and Mrs. Claus. Then we do the tree lighting at night, the ice skating rink, the corral.
It's lit.
The ballerinas from the Nutcracker. It has everything. Hot cocoa, a mini train, a Clydesdale walking around with a carriage. You can't miss it. So that's happening at Reston Town Center in Reston for those of you in the area. And that happens on Black Friday. And then you can go do some shopping. So if you are out there that way, please say hello to me. It's one of the biggest things that I look forward to every year. That's right.
I missed.
Don't forget that Blangie's Alive IG story Hallmark Christmas movie night is going to be November 30th now, and it's at 6 p.m. Eastern time. We are watching Christmas at the Plaza. There's a big twist in this story. Well, no, there's not. It's just another Hallmark story. You've probably seen it before. So, but it's going to be great, and it's going to be fun. There will be Snuggies and lots of wine.
Yes.
Okay. Lots going on in December. That's when we're going to see you next. I can't believe it's December, which means that we can officially kick off the festive season. I can't think of anyone better to help us do that than Miss Amy Goodman. You know her from all the network shows. She's on Zulily. She's on everything. And she is going to come in, and she's going to show us how to get the party started. Yes. That's going to be fun. And speaking of parties, woo! We're gearing up. We're just days away Holly Dolly Christmas. Take it away, Dolly.
Put this on top.
Oh, beautiful. Then you can kill her around. Yeah. Course.
So cute.